JK, it actually feels pretty good. What's good, it's your boy Aaron here. Today, we're talking about foam rolling. Throughout my career, I spent so many hours on this bad boy, both for warming up my muscles and also recovery. So today I wanna break it down for you because I feel like a lot of people still think we're just rolling around like a floppy seal in this bad boy, but there's a lot of intention and benefits to foam rolling. So we got PJ here, Coach Jess here. We're gonna break down three things for you. Why do you foam roll? What types of foam rollers are there out there? And lastly, how to use the freaking thing. Let's get into it. As always, you want more fitness related content, make sure you like and subscribe. Foam rolling is what's called self-myofascial release. So we have this connective tissue in between our skin and our muscle, it's called fascia. When we're doing repetitive movements like sitting, working out, driving, inevitably we're gonna get these knots, these adhesions in the fascia. So we need to roll it out. So we're on the foam roller, we're doing these small repetitive movements on that knot, and we're rolling it out, we're like ironing it out. When you do that, you're helping relieve muscle tightness, relieve soreness and inflammation, and also it's gonna increase your joint range of motion, you're gonna perform way better. Lastly, it's gonna prevent injury because it alleviates the pressure on your joints and your muscles. So, we have all these different types of foam rollers. Coach PJ is gonna share with you how they work and which one's best for you.
Now you might understand a little bit of the why. Let's get to the what, and specifically what foam roller works best for you. Foam rollers come in all types of sizes, shapes, densities, textures, and they all serve a specific purpose, ultimately to help you become a better athlete, working on your flexibility, your range of motion, and relieving muscle pain. Now, when I started off foam rolling some 10 years ago, my coach taught me on a PVC pipe. Now, if you see, this is very dense and it's extremely painful, and it's not the best recommended way to start off if you're just beginning with foam rolling. My suggestion is gonna be working with something like this, a little softer foam, which is gonna be a little less dense, which will help you, again, still alleviate pain, but not be torture when it comes to working on your body. Now, there are other things like different ridges that are gonna have a certain texture, which will help you get into deeper muscles and different surface areas. There are things like spheres and temporary balls like this, or the lacrosse ball, which you can isolate feet, neck, even the hip areas. One of my favorite foam rollers of all time is the Viper by Hyperice. It's a vibrating foam roller, so it's going to work both vibration and it's going to work that pressure, as you're going to still get the same benefits as other foam rollers, just a little more assistance. And recently, I've been using other percussion tools like the Theragun and the Hypervolt for a little bit more rapid foam rolling. Also, it can be really specific with the type of attachments that it comes with to get even deeper in different places that you couldn't quite hit with a foam roller like this. Now you know a little bit of the why and the what, let's head over to Jess to see where you'll be using these foam rollers at.
Now let's imagine that you have one of these. Let's talk body parts. I'm gonna go over 10 of the most common body parts that you should roll out, especially if you do full body workouts or train boxing and kickboxing. The upper back, your lats, your glutes, hamstrings, calves, your quads and or IT band, your groin and hip flexors, your feet, and your chest and delts.
Ah, thank you. All right, guys, there you have it. Foam rolling is essential. We have to train hard, but we also have to recover. So if you're interested in foam rolling, and you should be, jump over to the Fight Camp YouTube page and try our follow-along videos. And if you're interested in boxing and kickboxing related content, go to joinfightcamp.com for the best at-home interactive kickboxing and boxing workouts. My name's Aaron Swenson, PJ and Jess. We'll check you on the next one. Os.